that satisfying crunch and savory browned flavor from your favorite potato chips, or your regular cereal, or your preferred fast food French fries. Where do these delicious traits come from? Well, research has found that there is one mysterious hidden ingredient which becomes unlocked once cooked and gives your food that crispy texture and hearty flavor. But here's the thing. It may also lead to some serious consequences for your body, especially if you are already managing erratic blood sugar. In fact, this secret chemical is now classified as a probable carcinogen. So what is it? We're about to investigate and discover if this really is the most dangerous hidden ingredient for diabetics. Now, here's something incredible to consider. This mystery ingredient isn't actually an added ingredient in the traditional sense. So in many cases, you won't see it listed in the ingredients list on the packaging for most of the foods in which this substance can be found. How is that possible? And what is this crazy chemical anyway? Well, have you ever heard of acrylamide? This is an organic compound that is not specifically added to food products, but thanks to a chemical process called the Maillard reaction, acrylamide can form within some foods once they are heated to a high enough temperature. It's so named thanks to French chemist Louis-Camille Maillard, who discovered and described this reaction in 1912. Here's how it works. When certain foods are rich in starches and amino acids, especially the amino acid asparagine, are exposed to heat above 120 degrees Celsius or 250 degrees Fahrenheit, it produces several compounds, including some that give the heated food more complex flavors and an inviting brown hue. But if the food stays at this high heat for a prolonged period, the asparagine will react with the starchy sugars and another unintended compound will form, that being acrylamide. In fact, the higher the temperature and the longer the cooking or baking time, the more acrylamide is likely to be created. But what is so wrong with this chemical anyways? And within which foods is acrylamide secretly lurking? We're about to answer those questions and much more, so stick around. First, don't forget to like and subscribe. And you've got 3 free diabetes management guides waiting for you. Simply click the link in the description below, and they're all yours. Okay, so what will happen to your body if you consume too much acrylamide? And what does it have to do with diabetes? Before we answer those questions, it's important to know which foods can secretly supply this potentially toxic compound. So, we've already established that acrylamide can be formed within carbohydrate-rich foods that are subjected to high temperatures, either before they are packaged or upon being cooked at restaurants or by you at home. So, this should clue you in as to which foods will supply this chemical. They include fried potato products like French fries and potato chips, baked carb-heavy products like mini breads, pastries, and crackers, processed carb-heavy products like cookies, pretzels, biscuits, and microwave popcorn, breakfast cereals, especially sugar-loaded, heavily processed cereal products, and even many types of coffee, including roasted coffee beans, brewed coffee, and instant coffee products. So, yeah, as it turns out, many of your most favorite foods and drinks may secretly supply acrylamide. But do any packaged food products offer any clues to help you know if they will secretly expose your body to this substance? We'll show you how to know which foods give you acrylamide later in this video. But right now, let's investigate the effects that this mysterious compound actually creates for your body. And what is its connection to your blood sugar? Well, first off, based on limited animal studies, acrylamide is now classified by the International Agency for Research on Cancer as a probable human carcinogen, meaning it may have the ability to cause cancer. And the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency classifies acrylamide as likely to be carcinogenic to humans. But what does this mean, really? Here's the truth. Multiple studies suggest that there is not actually a strong association between consuming acrylamide via foods and developing cancer. Some animal studies have found a link between acrylamide exposure and cancer, but they involved extremely high amounts of the compound. In fact, far larger quantities of acrylamide than a typical human would ever ingest. But where acrylamide is a real concern, for its potential cancer-causing effects at least, is through skin contact or inhalation of concentrated amounts of acrylamide. This can occur in industrial settings, like chemical manufacturing plants, oil and gas recovery, and fracking areas, water treatment facilities, textile manufacturing, certain construction sites, especially tunnel engineering, some laboratory research and biomedical facilities, and even pulp and paper processing mills. Some industrial pesticides and herbicides may also contain acrylamide-related compounds. Now, while research does show that the most serious damage only occurs from exposure to extremely high levels of acrylamide, to a point that it should really not concern you, the simple fact is, in the US, there are currently no regulations on the presence of acrylamide within food products. The FDA does regulate the amount of residual acrylamide in certain materials that come in contact with these food products, but they do not review or limit the amount of acrylamide within the foods themselves. Instead, the FDA only provides guidance and suggestions to food corporations on how to reduce the amount of acrylamide in their products. But these are only recommendations. However, the Environmental Protection Agency does regulate the amount of acrylamide in drinking water. And in workplace environments, acrylamide amounts are regulated by the EPA as well as the Occupational Safety and Health Administration. Okay, now, what conclusions can we draw from all this? Well, in terms of your cancer risk, you shouldn't have too much worry for the amount of acrylamide in your food. And if your job requires you to work in an industrial setting where acrylamide may be present, there should be regulations in place which protect you from dangerously high levels of exposure. Phew. So what's the big deal about acrylamide and diabetes then? We'll get to the real worry and danger of consuming acrylamide, especially if you are already concerned about your blood sugar, in just a moment. First, are you concerned about hidden ingredients in your food? Which foods do you try to limit or completely avoid, and why? Comment below to let us know. And if you support common sense blood sugar management, let the world know by smashing that thumbs up. Okay, so let's talk about the hidden links between diabetes and the hidden ingredient, acrylamide. This chemical may exist in your food in small enough quantities for you not to worry about the risks of developing cancer, but studies have found that acrylamide consumption is linked to a variety of health concerns, especially for diabetics. Firstly, it may act as a neurotoxin, and it can create oxidative stress and inflammation, especially in the nervous system, and even in the brain. In fact, animal studies involving diabetic lab rats revealed that acrylamide consumption can increase the risk of worsened memory, cognitive impairment, and other metabolic disturbances in the brain. Indeed, these trials have found that diabetic rats who were fed acrylamide-rich foods developed neuropathy symptoms faster than test subjects who did not consume acrylamide. And thanks to these studies, scientists have concluded that diabetics who regularly consume acrylamide-rich foods may increase their risk of nerve damage. Meanwhile, other research has found a link between acrylamide consumption and pancreatic beta cell damage. That means this chemical has the ability to interfere with your body's production of insulin, potentially leading to reduced insulin secretion and worsened glucose metabolism. Results of other animal studies suggest that acrylamide may exacerbate previous diabetes-related liver damage, and diabetics may face a heightened risk of liver toxicity from acrylamide exposure. Plus, research has linked regular acrylamide intake with an increased risk of developing cardiovascular disease, suggesting that diabetics who consume large amounts of acrylamide-rich foods have a higher likelihood of experiencing heart-related issues. One study published in the journal Frontiers even suggested that exposure to acrylamide is linked to an increased risk of cardiovascular disease-caused death for those already suffering from high blood sugar. All told, epidemiological studies indicate that a higher acrylamide intake is associated with an increased risk of developing type 2 diabetes, especially for women. So, what does this tell us then? While you shouldn't have much fear of acrylamide causing you to develop cancer, you should avoid overconsuming this chemical if you already suffer from diabetes. But as this is essentially a hidden ingredient, how can you know which foods may secretly supply acrylamide? Here's how to identify packaged and pre-cooked food products that contain acrylamide. Number 1. Check the ingredients list. Watch out for foods with high amounts of carbohydrates and sugars that have already been pre-fried, baked, or roasted at high temperatures. These often include potato, wheat, or corn products. Number 2. Check the cooking method. Check the packaging for keywords like fried, roasted, toasted, or baked. You can decrease your risk of purchasing an acrylamide-rich food if you choose products that use lower heat cooking methods or foods that are not pre-cooked. So that means looking for keywords like boiled, steamed, or even raw. Number 3. Watch for warning labels. In some states, especially California, food manufacturers are legally required to provide a warning label on packaged foods which contain acrylamide above a certain level. That label may have a wording like, "This product contains a chemical known to the state of California to cause cancer." Which food items are more prone to having these labels? Well, watch for these warnings on the packaging of coffee, potato chip, french fry, pre-baked products, and even baby food. If you reside in other parts of the country, know that many food manufacturers still provide information on their acrylamide mitigation methods. So if you are concerned about a specific product, check the company website before you buy. Also, the FDA regularly tests foods and publishes regular reports on acrylamide levels in current products, so be sure to check their website and publications as well. In Europe, the European Food Safety Authority monitors acrylamide levels in food products created and sold throughout the EU, and they may add warning labels to some of these products. Number 4. Choose different products. In some cases, food corporations will go the extra mile and offer low acrylamide versions of their products. So you may see packaging that specifically mentions this, especially for baby food and coffee substitutes. But at the end of the day, it will be all around better for your blood sugar, your weight management, and your heart and brain health to simply limit your intake of pre-cooked, high-carbohydrate foods. And at home, you can reduce acrylamide in your kitchen by making sure to not overcook your starchy foods. That means, by all means, pan-fry or bake your favorite dish. But try to stop once it's lightly golden brown, instead of waiting until it's a darker shade of brown or blackened. Also, soak your potatoes in water before frying or baking. This removes some starch content and helps to reduce the amount of acrylamide which forms. So, yeah, when all is said and done, avoiding acrylamide is just another reason to cut back on all those typical glucose-spiking, highly refined food items like cookies, chips, cereals, french fries, processed snack foods, and, of course, white bread.